So now we'll talk about the moving of the going of the light rays. ठीक है, light rays going from air to glass and again, okay, and again from glass to air. Again, here also we are talking about refraction only, right? So now see, separately we have seen, separately we have seen what happens when the light rays moves from rarer medium to denser medium, what happens when the light rays move from denser medium to the rarer medium. Now we'll see, like, if you have to draw a diagram together, then how will it come up to? So this is my glass slab and I have named it as usual PQRS, right? Now this is our air, so rarer medium. This is glass, so obviously denser medium, but here again air, so rarer medium. Remember, in refraction we have to talk about an oblique ray, right? So here, when an oblique, when a ray of light falls obliquely on the point O, here I can name it as A, it is coming, so I put this arrow. Now I'll draw one normal over here to make the things easy, right? Now this is our N O N dash, right? Now when the ray of light moves from rarer medium to denser medium, it will see, it should go like this, isn't it? It should go like this. But it is not going in this way and it moves towards the normal, right? It moves towards the normal. Now here, you know, if I want to write the incident rays, reflected ray, incident angle and reflected angle. So incident ray, it will be like AO. AO is our incident ray, right? Now refracted, this we don't have to write, children, actually, right? Just I'm explaining you, and so I'm writing. Now this is refracted one, so I can name it as, you know, anything, like maybe B, right? Now this angle has to be represented by R, because it is angle of refraction. Incident angle is which one? This is angle I, right? So it will be A O N. This is incident angle, angle of incidence, right? Now angle of refraction is which one? Now it is N dash O B. This is angle of refraction, and refracted ray is which one? O B. Again we'll talk over here. A O is an incident ray which falls, which incident on the point O, it get refracted from this point O and it comes as OB. This is the original path where the ray should come and travel actually, but it is moving towards the normal as the light rays are traveling from rarer medium to denser medium, right? Now I have to show all together everything here only, so I'll extend this, right? I'll extend this and I'll come up to here. Now this is my point B. Now this is an incident ray for this slab and it has to come out, right? So I'll have to draw one normal again here for this one. This one can be n1 and n1 dash, right? This one again a normal n1b n1 dash. Now here this will come and it should actually follow the same this one path, but here it is coming out and it is moving away from the normal, right? And this angle is known as emergent angle, children. I can name it as C, right? Now BC is an emergent ray. Okay, one more ray we have to write over here. It is emergent ray. Now emergent ray is EC and angle of emergence is N1BC. So it is N1BC. Now again we'll try to understand what had happened over here. See children, this is the ray of light which is coming from the air. It is moving towards the glass slab. This is a rarer medium, this is a denser medium, again this is a rarer medium. AO is an incident ray which incident at the point O and it makes the angle of incidence with the normal. Okay, this ray AO makes the angle of incidence with the normal NO and dash, right? Now this should actually follow this path. Okay, this ray should actually follow this path, which I can write over here, give your name as D. Okay, it should be actually AOD, but what had happened, this had got refracted from here. Now N dash O and B is the refracted angle. Okay, N dash OB is a refracted angle, whereas OB is a refracted ray. Now this one for here is an incident ray. Now this incident ray for this, get, you know, it is coming out from the glass slab. So it is emerging out from the glass slab. So this angle is known as emergent angle, angle of emergence. So here this, I have denoted this with E, and this is angle of emergence. Now, you know, you can see this distance, children, this perpendicular distance. Okay, this perpendicular distance between, okay, between the this the original path of the incident ray and the emergent ray is known as lateral displacement, children. This is known as lateral displacement. So if I have to define lateral displacement, how I will define lateral displacement? Right? Now the perpendicular distance, right, between where it is, the perpendicular distance, the perpendicular distance. Okay, see, you can see this, this is, if I extend this like this, so this is a perpendicular distance between the original path, okay, between the original path of the incident ray. So the perpendicular distance between the original path, okay, the original path of what, children? This is an original path of the incident ray. So original path of the incident ray and this is what, children? This is the emergent ray, isn't it? So the perpendicular distance between the original incident ray and the emergent ray, and the emergent ray, it is known as what? The lateral displacement. That means it should have come here, but it has come over here, and the distance between these two is known as lateral displacement. Now one more thing, children, you can see that here refraction has taken place. So this, see, actually, you know, PQ, okay, the PQ, side PQ and the side SR, okay, now the side PQ and the side SR, they are actually, you know, equal and opposite side. Which kind of sides are they? they are equal and opposite sides. Right? So these two sides are equal sides and opposite side. So you know actually what has happened, children, over here, the displacement of AB, that try to understand, the displacement of OB towards the normal and the displacement of BC away from the normal is equal, right? So this, again I'm saying the same thing, this is again, there are a lot of things to study in this, to understand, but this will be in the higher classes, it will be in 10th standard. So for this, for the 8th standard, to understand refraction till here, I think will be quite sufficient. So here in this diagram, we have studied like what happens where the refraction takes place, how the refraction angle is formed when the you know, ray of light will move towards the normal, when it is going to move away from the normal, right? What is the angle of emergence, or what is the emergent ray? It is coming out from the slab, so it is emergent ray. Okay, this angle is emergent angle. This displacement is known as lateral displacement. What is that? The distance, which kind of distance? This is perpendicular. So the perpendicular distance between the original incident ray, this was our original incident ray, and the emergent ray, right? This is known as lateral displacement. You know, in case if we take you know, some other medium, what medium can we take? If we take air, water and air, air, water and air, in that case also the same diagram will be made, right? So this was about the refraction in short. Now, you know, actually what are the, you like, what are the effects, how the effects of refraction can be seen, children? So you know, actually, so now we'll talk about effects of refraction. Okay, effects of refraction. Now actually what happened, you know, children, if you go to swimming pool, the swimming pool appears to be little less deeper, you know, little less deeper. So it happens due to what? Due to a refraction. Swimming pool appears to be little less deeper. Alright? So swimming pool appears to be little less deeper. Then if you keep lemon, okay, lemon, where if you keep? If you keep lemon in the glass container, glass beaker filled with water, glass container filled with water, it appears to be bigger from side. It appears to be bigger. If you look it from the side, okay, if you take a glass beaker, fill it with water, you keep lemon into that, and then you see it from the side, so it will, yeah, it will appear to be bigger, again due to refraction. Then twinkling of stars, right? Twinkling of stars, it appears, children, due to the refraction, right? Now if you keep a stick, okay, oblique, a stick is kept obliquely, stick kept, I will not be able to write now, kept obliquely in water will appear to be water will appear to be raised one, right? So these all are the effects of you know, refraction. There are many other effects also. It is, these all are effects of refraction, right? And what I'm saying, there are many other effects also which can be observed and seen. You know, atmospheric refraction is also there, due to which the, you know, the sun, the timings, you know, what actually sun rises and what actually it appears to be. So it is all there, little difference is there, 2 minute difference is there. So like, we'll talk about that at some other time. So for here, the effects of refraction, this is the effects of refraction which we have studied. Now if we take an example, you know, suppose like if I want to show like how the stick seems to be raised one, so just we'll have a talk about that, like how a stick seems to be raised when it is kept in the water. So just we'll discuss about that. Note this point, and so that we can discuss that one. Thank you.